the original Green Lantern, the Alan Scott Green Lantern, there was one ring, one ring bearer, and he was the one who wielded all its power. He really was a product of his times. He fought gangsters, you know. He also fought during World War II, fought the Nazis, fought along those lines. Then when the characters disappeared for a while and the thought came back to reimagine them, Hal Jordan's Green Lantern was born in a time that the space race was at its peak.
In 1959, pilots were big-time heroes.
I loved that period of time. I loved how hopeful America was. But I think anytime we hearken back to that, we hearken to a time of enthusiasm, a positive thinking.
Naturally, stories like that, ideas like that, are the fertile ground for science fiction storytelling.
It was time to do a Green Lantern movie.
As with all of these movies, the biggest challenge we have is to not repeat things that we've done before.
This particular Green Lantern movie is not based on any specific source material.
If you're gonna do, you know, Green Lantern, you kinda need his most iconic villain.
It's kind of a Training Day sort of story where we have the veteran space cop and the rookie space cop.
We spend so little time on Earth in this movie. Almost the entire length of the movie takes place in outer space. It doesn't look like Wonder Woman, and it doesn't look like, you know, the Matsuda Batman or anything. I mean, it's actually a very unique style. It's a big galactic adventure.
Chosen you.